She comes back to New York. You know, New York is now starting, you know, it started, it's 1922, and the, you know, the Harlem Renaissance is sort of starting, and she decides that, you know, she's the impresario. She decides to have a big wedding for my grandmother. My grandmother, as you can see, has really long braids, and their main product was Wonderful Hair Grower. My grandmother was adopted by Alelia Walker, who was married three times but had no biological children. And this is a longer story than I can really go into today, but she, her grandmother, biological grandmother, lived across the alley from Madam Walker in Indianapolis. And May began to work as a model and travel with them, and they persuaded her mother, who was still living, to let them legally adopt her with the promise that they would educate her and that she would be involved in the business. So she traveled with them. They sent her to Spelman. She graduated from Spelman with honors, I was happy to find when I was doing my research. And then Lilia founds the Harlem Debutante Club for May, so that May will meet the proper young ladies. Lucille Green Randolph, A. Philip Randolph's wife, is the co-sponsor of the debutantes, which is like such an interesting combination, because A. Philip Randolph was so not about that society thing. So it's an interesting combination. They're both really interesting people. Now, May has lots of beaux that she's interested in. This is from her scrapbook. I sort of like all of these fine young men. But I know from reading the what was then an unpublished biography or memoir by Anita Thompson, the book that's just come out as American Cocktail. In that book, she talks about May's wedding. She's a bridesmaid in the wedding. And she writes about how unhappy May was and that May was really in love with somebody else. But Lilia decides to arrange this marriage. She sends out 10,000 invitations, and she matches May with Dr. Gordon Jackson, the evil Dr. Gordon Jackson, who's 14 years older than she, you know, not a nice guy, but he's from a very prominent black family. His grandfather, Robert Gordon, had become very wealthy, formerly enslaved person who had a coal yard in Cincinnati who made a lot of money. His father was an attorney and a state legislator in Ohio who was the treasurer for the Niagara movement. And Lilia thought this was a match made in heaven, you know, I guess a la some of these wealthy New York families and European royalty. So May, as you can see, is not happy. Not happy. But beautiful, beautiful dress with all of this detail on the dress, everything made by black designers. Bridesmaids from prominent families. Eunice Hunton is one of the bridesmaids. Anita Thompson, you know, just, you know, Alelia has handpicked the bridesmaids. The groomsmen are all doctors and lawyers. This is my uncle who was born the next year, the child of Gordon and May, but May gets the heck out of Dodge. I mean, they're in Chicago. She's like, I got to get out of here. So she moves back to New York. These are the divorce papers. I'm so happy for May. So she moves back to New York. And while the summer that she's back, one of Lilia's friends, actually her sister-in-law, estranged from the evil Dr. Wiley Wilson, introduces her to my grandfather, who's in this picture because he was on the Lincoln football team. So this just reminds me. He was studying finance at Columbia for the summer. He was already a lawyer. He'd gone to University of Pittsburgh. So they meet, and they elope because she doesn't want another big wedding. And then Lilia marries Kennedy a couple of years later. So finally, she's doing the business. She's taking care of business, but the Harlem Renaissance is really starting to blow up.